Hello, Manchester! What a fantastic turnout once again. You know, the media have been asking me, why are you in Manchester today? And we're here in order to send a very clear message to this Tory government. If they thought on May the 7th that we were going to disappear, well, think again, because we're here to fight for everything that belongs to us. Our welfare state, our national health service, universal education. We're here to fight for decent jobs, secure jobs, decent homes, and a future for our kids. And if they think that a fluke victory in which 75% of the electorate didn't vote for gives them a mandate to continue with their attacks, then they've got another thing coming. If they think they're going to have a smooth ride for the next 5 years, they've got another thing coming, because there will be hundreds and thousands of people hounding them, staffing at them and resisting. And you know, it is for me important today to recognise our workers from Red Car Steel Factory. And I know all of you would want to send your solidarity to those workers and their communities fighting for a future. You know, the Prime Minister, he's pretty good at telling jokes. He reckons that the Conservatives are the Workers' Party. Really? Well, if he is, I say this to him. Step in now and save Red Car Steel Plant. That's exactly what the French government have done, and it's exactly what the Italian government done when this announcement was made. If it's good enough for Italian steel workers, where's our government for our steel workers? This march is not only about austerity, it's also about fighting the attacks on trade unions. No sooner was the ink dry on the election results than the first attack they made was on trade unions. As Liz said, it's because they know we are the last line of defence. It always amuses me when they say in their newspapers and on TV, well, the trade unions are irrelevant now. They're not as important as they used to be. And I think to myself, well, if that's the case, why do they keep attacking us? And of course they attack us because they know what we represent and what values we represent. This trade union bill is pernicious. It's designed to turn trade unions into nothing more than advice agencies. And my message from Unite is clear. We will stand by our members in struggle, and if that means taking us outside of the law, then so be it. And that's why, sisters and brothers, that's why, comrades, that we need to build an alliance. We need to build an alliance with direct action groups, with community organisations, with faith organisations, with our Labour Party, who at last has a leader that will stand shoulder to shoulder with us. Because when that time comes, as I believe it will, then we have to demonstrate that all adults, that workers united will never be defeated. I'll finish on this point, comrades. There's an old adage that if you fight, you may not always win. But if you don't fight, you will surely lose. That's what we need to do. Believe in our values. Believe in our strength. Have confidence in ordinary working people. And united, we will achieve victory. Cheers, comrades.
And here we are, the Hearts of Manchester, the biggest university in the world.